स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अनदर यूनिट, यूनिट 7, इन विच चैप्टर नंबर इज 5। ऑलरेडी वी हैव डन 4 चैप्टर। सो इन दिस चैप्टर, चैप्टर नेम इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन, एंड द यूनिट इज जेनेटिक्स एंड एवोल्यूशन। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर अबाउट सम जेनेटिक्स। Fine. So here, as the chapter name indicates, inheritance and variation. Fine. So the definition which we are going to cover here, I have written all important definitions. So we will start with the first definition, genetics. So we are talking about the whole unit about genetics. So it is very, very essential for us to understand what is genetics and about which we are talking about. Fine. So genetics is a study. It's a branch of science and it is a study of what? Heredity and evolution. So here, what you will say? Genetics is the study of heredity and evolution. So now, what are these two terms? What is the meaning of heredity and what is the meaning of evolution? So here, another definition comes here, heredity. It means that, as you know, that you are getting some character from your parents, either from mother or from father, or sometimes from both. So here, what happens that whatever the character which you are getting, it is known as heredity, the transmission of character from one parents to the coming generation. So it is a heredity. And another one is variation. Variation means the differences which are existing among the individual. We know that if, for example, two siblings are there and both are coming from the parents. So if you will say that, if you will compare them, they are not exactly the same. Even sometimes the progeny is not exactly same with their parents. Some variation is there. It means that some dissimilarities is present in the progeny as we will compare with the parents. Fine. So this is the variation. Now in this genetics, we are studying about those character, how these characters are transmitting, as well as what are the changes we are getting in the subsequent generation. So when we are studying about these two things, it comes under genetics. Alright. Now another one is inheritance. So we are using this term as a synonym of what? As the heredity. Why? Because heredity is what? The character which we are getting from our parents, and that process. Inheritance is what? Inheritance is a process in which we are coming to know that what is the transmission of character from parents to their offspring. So in very simple language, we can say it is a process of transmission of character from parents to their offspring or their coming generation. Fine. Now, another definition is character. We always confuse between these two terms, character and trait. They are somehow related to each other. They are, what are they? They are comparable. We can say both are the same thing. So, how we can define the character and how we can define the trait? Okay. So, for example, if I say I have two markers of this, these two markers, so how can you say that what will be the character and what will be the trait? When how can you distinguish between these two markers? You can differentiate between these two markers on the basis of what? On the basis of colors. You can say it's a blue color and it's a red color marker. Fine. So what it is, we are talking about some character, we are talking about the color. Fine. Likewise, if I will say that height of any individual, for example, if it is a taller height and another one is a shorter height, so we are talking about what? We are talking about the height. So whenever we are talking about any character or on the basis of which we are differentiating them, okay, so it comes under the character. And what is trait then? When we are saying that we have this differentiated on the basis of colors, and what type of color? Red color and blue color. So these two things will become trait. Fine. So what is character? Character is what? We can say that character is the color, or on the basis, for example, color, height, all these are the different character. And what is trait? If we will go beyond that, what is the color and what will be the height, so it comes under the trait. Fine. So we will discuss more about in the Mendel's experiment, how he has given different character or how he has taken different traits on the basis of which he conducted his experiment. Fine. Another one is allele. Here students, we are talking about the character of allele. For example, if I say that about the color, it's a red color and another one is a blue color. So we said both comes under the character, and if we will show this color with a capital one, and if I show this another one is the small one, okay, it doesn't mean that I have taken blue or any color. So it's a dominant part and it's a recessive part. So if I say about the color, so we can say this color having which type of gene? Different red color gene and another one is a blue color gene. So what will be the allele? Allele is the differentiating character. Okay, allele can be the character which is present in the gene. For example, in this one, it is having this color gene and this are having another color gene. So it will decide what? It is one of the allele and this will become the another allele. Fine. So another way which I can explain you, if you will take the Mendelian experiment, plant height, capital T and small t. Fine. This character denotes what? Whole. It denotes the gene. Gene for what? Gene for the height or gene for the plant height. When I am talking about the allele, allele is one of the form which is present in the gene. We can say that allele are the basis for the inheritance. Okay, allele, why? Because in inheritance, the gene is transferring from parents to offspring. So this contains what? One different type of allele and another different type of allele. Fine. Here I am talking about the monohybrid cross. We can say that this allele can be of different types in the dihybrid cross also. Fine. Another one is the homologous chromosome. What is homologous chromosome? See, when you have drawn the structure of chromosome, okay, structure of chromosome, we all know that in any cell, okay, whether it is a plant cell or animal cell, what is there? There is a nucleus. Inside the nucleus, what is present? Genetic material, or we can say chromosomes are present. If they are chromosome, they are having some chromatin fibers. These chromosomes are made up of what? The condensation of chromatin fibers. And in this when you will zoom this chromatin fibers, so what you will say that there is a genetic material. And what will be the genetic material? The genetic material is the DNA. What is it? DNA. We know that the structure of DNA is a double helical structure. So in these DNA, what is present? Gene is present. Or we can say the gene is what? Is a segment of DNA. If I will talk in this 12th number of definition, if we have to understand about the gene. Gene is what? It's a segment of this DNA which is responsible for different character. Some gene is responsible for the color of eyes in case of human, some responsible for the color of hairs, some responsible for the height of the individual. So we are having different gene of and these genes are present where? In our DNA. Fine. And another thing which we have to know about the homologous chromosome. Homologous means that if you will recall the structure of the chromosome in human beings, how many chromosomes are present? We can say 46 or 23 pairs. See students, these chromosomes are present in pairs. For example, this is one chromosome and this one is the another chromosome. So how many pairs are there? How many pairs are there? One pair. So it is combining one. Again, another pair will form another one. So we are having how many pairs? 23 pairs. So out of these 23 pairs, 22 pairs are what? These are the same. And there is only difference of only one pair. Okay. There is a difference of only one pair in the difference between the male and female. And what is that one? The XX chromosome and XY chromosome. So the 22 pairs which are same, it is known as what? It is known as homologous chromosome, fine, and the one pair of chromosome which is different one, okay, which will decide the gender of an individual, that whether it is XX or whether it is XY. Okay, so these pair decide the gender. So we can say, when we are talking about this pair, we can say it is a heterologous chromosome, and when we are talking about these 22 pairs which are same, or we can say these are autosome, these chromosomes are also known as autosomes, and another one, that one pair which is different, which is known as allosomes. So here we have done what is homologous chromosome and what is heterologous. Homo means same and hetero means different, on the same locus, or we can say the in locus they are different one, fine. Now another one is monohybrid and dihybrid cross. See student, mono relates to what? It means one, and di relates to two. Whenever we are going to cross between the same character, or we can say when we are talking about, when we are considering about one character, okay. See, as we are, what is meaning of cross? Cross means taking the character and combining to form a hybrid. For example, if I say I have that capital T and small t, right? This capital T denotes what? Tall, and this small t denotes dwarf. So here, what character I have taken? I have taken the height of the plant. Height of the plant, or we can say plant height. So how many character I am considering here? Only one character, and we are going to cross between this tall plant and the dwarf plant. So what type of cross it will be? Monohybrid cross. It means that hybrid or that cross which we are going to do, and we are considering only one character, or we can say that study of one character at a time. So at a time what we are taking? Only one character, and what is that character? Height, right? So it is a monohybrid cross. Another one is a dihybrid. Di means two. When we are taking another character, for example, along with this character, if I will rub this one, in Mendel's also, he took the dihybrid cross. How? He has taken the, we can say, color as well as the flower, or we can say he has taken, as I have mentioned, he has seven characters. Okay, so out of these seven characters, he has taken two character, or he has studied two character at a time. So it will be the dihybrid cross. So how we can say that I have taken pot color? It can be green or yellow, or the seed shape, round and wrinkled. If we will study about these two character at a time, so what can be the characters? The pot color can be, for example, round. Okay, here I have denoted with this one, and another one which we are taking here, another character, it can be the YY. Okay, so we are taking what? We are taking here another two character. We are talking about the two character. If I will make crosses between them, okay, this can be what? Capital R and small r. So this capital R denote what? It denotes the round one. Okay, whatever I have mentioned here earlier, these are the dominant character, and another one is a recessive character. So here, what will be the dominant character? Round. And another small r denotes what? Recessive character. Now another time, what we have taken? Another green and yellow. If I have shown this green color with capital Y, okay, and another one I have shown with the small y, fine. So when we are going to cross between these two, okay, when we are going to crossing between these two, or we can say that if I have taken ry here and ry here, okay, so what we will get here? RRYY. So what we have done here? Two character we have taken, and we are getting the f1 of crossing these two different traits, or we can say different characters, fine. So now the another one is gene. What is gene? As we have done, gene is the segment of what? Of the DNA, which will decide the transmission of character from parents to the offspring. Okay, another one is phenotype and genotype. Now, what is the difference between phenotype and genotype? When we are talking about the outer appearance, okay, the physical appearance of any plant, of any human beings, so it is known as phenotype. And what is genotype? The genetic constitution of any individual, which will decide the structure of internal one as well as external one. It is known as genotype. For example, if I say about the phenotype, so the plant or the flower color may be red color or it can be white color. So how we are deciding here? On the basis of their color. On the basis of their color, red color and white color, it shows the phenotype. When we are talking about some genotypic, for example, if in the genetic constitution there will be some changes or recombination, so what it will decide? It will be decided by the genotype. Another one is dominant, and that one is recessive. So what is the difference between dominant and recessive? Here, as we have done this example, capital T and small t. Capital T shows what? It shows the dominant character, and this small t shows the dwarf character. Fine. So what is the meaning of dominant? That character which is showing in the heterozygote condition. What is it? In two terms, again we have to discuss about the homozygote and heterozygote. For example, I have shown here capital T, small t, and small t, and small t. Okay, as you have done already in 10th grade, how we have done combination, or how we have made the crosses according to the Mendel's law. So here the condition in which both alleles are the same, so we can say, what are they? These are the homozygotes. When there are difference between these two, capital T and small t, it denotes what? It denotes the heterozygote condition. So when in heterozygote condition, the character which is showing the more, for example, here in this heterozygote condition, which is dominant one, the capital T is dominant one, which will, what it will do? It will repress the character of the dwarf. Okay, it will suppress its characteristics of dwarf. So this is known as dominant. And what is recessive? Recessive is that which is not able to express itself in the heterozygote condition. For example, here also, if you see capital T and small t, so this small t is not able to express itself, and in spite of that, the capital T is expressing. So on the basis of this, we can say dominant as well as recessive one. And here we have added one more thing. What? Homozygote and heterozygote condition. Fine. So now another one is character. Okay. As we know that Mendel's did his experiment in which plant? This question is experiment in which plant? In pea plant. So here the question can be that what is in which plant he did his experiment, and what is the scientific name? What is the scientific name of pea? Pisum sativa. Fine. So in this plant, he did his experiment and taken the 7 different characters. On the basis of this, he has concluded his results. Fine. So we will not discuss all about it. So we will discuss about this thing in the later session. So here, now if we'll conclude that whole the things which we have done today, that about the introductory part of this chapter, in which we have covered some definitions which are the basic for this chapter. And now for the additional information, I would like to add the genetics. Genetics can be of 3 types. Okay, on the basis of their functioning, we have classified into different genetics. For example, the first type 1 genetics, we can say that the transmission genetics. What is mean of transmission? It means that passing the character from parents to the offspring. Whenever we are talking about these transmission of character, so it comes under what type of genetics? In the transmission genetics. Fine. And another one is what? Molecular genetics. In molecular genetics, what does it mean? Whatever the constitution, or we can say genetic constitution of an individual, and we are studying about the structure of chromosomes, about the structure of the parts of the genetics, genetic constitution, it comes under what type of genetics? It will be the what we can say? Molecular genetics. Fine. Another one is the population genetics. Whatever we are doing here, we are studying about the Mendel Mendel's law, we are studying all the different laws or the things which we are studying here, if we are applying on the large population. So it comes under what? It comes under the population genetics. So in different parts we will study, even in the next chapter we will study about the chromosomal part, how the molecular organization is there. So we will study all about it. Fine. So that's all for this session. Fine. Thank you.